Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Mac. You probably don't know me, but I've been working behind the scenes editing videos and doing some recording for the Human Farming Guys. This is the first video I've appeared in this summer, but hopefully I'll be in some upcoming videos as well. Today, we're going to be doing a simple Arduino project. We'll be building A.P.E.X, a smart plant monitoring device. This guy will plug into any plant and display the happiness of the plant based on its soil moisture. As the plant dries out and the soil moisture goes down, A.P.E.X will look sad. But if there's plenty of water, A.P.E.X will look happy. It's a simple project that will teach you the basics of Arduino, how to code, and also some simple wiring and soldering. Should be a pretty fun video, and I hope you guys enjoy. Let's get into it. All right, first up, we're going to need an Arduino. This one is a cheap Chinese knockoff, but it'll do the job. Next, we need an 8x8 LED display. It's important that you have the 5-pin version for our code, so make sure to compare yours to the one in the link below the video. We're also going to need a moisture sensor, and we're going to need a capacitive touch sensor. Lastly, we need a 9-volt battery Arduino connector. These come in handy for making the project portable. Oh, I almost forgot this one. We're also going to need a battery. Okay, that's all the materials we'll need for this project. Next up, tools. At the top of our list is, of course, a soldering iron. We're going to need this to solder all the components together for our final project. Secondly, you're going to need a computer. It doesn't have to be a laptop, can be a desktop, or anything that's capable of downloading the Arduino IDE. This will work with Linux, Windows, and Mac. There's a few other things on our list for tools. Not all of them are necessary, but they're all good to have. These include wire strippers, a desoldering gun, Rosencore solder, 22 gauge wire, electrical tape, and last but not least, a breadboard. Next, I'm going to teach you the basics of setting up the Arduino. First off, turn your computer on and plug the Arduino in. USB cable goes in one end, and the other end goes in the computer. Alright, you're ready to code. Once you're on the desktop, open up Safari and go to arduino.cc. This is the main website for Arduino. We're going to navigate to the Software tab and click Downloads. Once you get to the Downloads page, scroll down and click on your respective operating system. This will take you to another page, click Just Download, and this will actually start the download. Once it downloads, we'll be able to click on it and click Open. This will install the Arduino software, and it'll be opened up right into the environment. All right, that's all we have to do. Now navigate over to Tools and make sure that these match. With the Arduino IDE set up, it's time to put together our breadboard. To start, we're going to grab the 8x8 LED. As you can see, it has 5 pins, so we're going to plug this into the breadboard. And then we're going to grab the cables that come with the LED. We're going to plug them into the back. Now we're going to take these cables, and we're going to take two of them, the voltage and ground, and we're going to plug them into their respective traces on the breadboard. Then we're going to take the other three cables, these are signal cables, and we're going to plug them into 12, 11, and 10. Make sure that the colors match up with the pins on the board. Refer to the circuit diagram if you need help with this. Okay, it's time for our water sensor. This one has 3 pins. We're going to go grab 3 wires, and we're going to plug these in. Now, for me, I have 2 female-to-female, so I plug the female-to-female into a male, so I can plug these into the breadboard. So, plug in, once again, the voltage and ground, and that'll leave us with a signal pin. This signal pin will go into A5 on the Arduino Uno. This is an analog pin, which will give us variable information. Once that's all hooked up, we're going to grab the button. This is our capacitive touch sensor. It also has 3 pins, ground, voltage, and signal. We're going to plug this into the board right beside our 8x8 LED display. We're going to grab another 3 cables. We're going to need one for voltage, one for ground, and one for signal. We're going to plug in red to voltage. We're going to plug in black to ground and orange to the signal. Now we're going to connect the red and the black, which is voltage and ground, we're going to connect those to the positive and negative terminals on the breadboard, and then we're going to connect the orange wire to the 7th position on the Arduino Uno. Okay, now it's time to plug in the power cables for the Arduino Uno. This is what's going to be powering everything. We want to put one into the ground and one into the 5 volts. We're going to run this in line with the positive and negative traces on the breadboard. Alright, it's time to test out the circuit. What we're going to do for this is we're going to grab the 9 volt battery and we're going to plug it in. It'll show a cancel sign for me because I have code already uploaded to the Arduino, but for you it should just display a fully on 8x8 LED. Alright, now it's time to discuss the code.
Here we have our folder on the desktop. Click it to unzip it. That'll make a folder, open that up, and double click on the program. This is the code we'll be discussing. Now I'm not going to get in depth on this code, but I do want to give you a brief overview for those of you who are interested in coding. Starting from the top, we have our include and define libraries, and then we also have all of our variables. These represent the values from the sensors, as well as including the libraries that are necessary for controlling the 8x8 LED display. At the bottom, you can see that there are bytes. These bytes represent the actual faces displayed on the 8x8 LED. These are bit values row by row in an array. Each array represents a different face, such as smile, surprise, meh, sad, dead, and error. Next is our setup function. This is where we start up the serial output and set up the 8x8 LED. We then have all of our methods for calling the different faces of the LED display. These aren't super important and they're fairly self-explanatory, so I won't get into detail. Okay, this is super important. This is our write Arduino on matrix function. What this does is take the values from the water sensor and calculate what face to put on the matrix. It then writes the face onto the matrix, and it updates every so often to make sure that the faces are correct. Last but not least is our loop function. This is what checks for button presses. We have to make sure that this is here so that we can turn the display on and off. And that's it for the code. Once you're ready to push, just go up to the top left and click the right arrow button. This will push the code to the Arduino.
Okay, now that the code is pushed, we're ready to test it out. So you should be seeing a cancel sign, just a little circle with a dash to it, and if we put our finger on it, you should see that it's sad or dead. Now if I put it on my tongue, you'll see that it's happy because it senses moisture. Awesome, that means the code is working. Great, so now we can unplug it from the computer, and let's test it on battery. Just take the cable, get it out of the way, and plug it in. And it works! Yes! Let's test it one more time with our finger. Oh, and it's dead, so it's working. Now it's time to put together the circuit, so I'm gonna do a short little montage of me soldering everything. Welcome back! Now that the project's done, all we have to do is test it out with an actual plant. Here I have a regular fern, so we're gonna pick up our little Apex, we're going to turn him on, so we need to plug in the battery first, and he should automatically turn on. And now it's time to plug him into the plant. So in he goes! Awesome! He's happy! Now you'll see, oh, he's surprised now, so obviously the plant is very, very watered. If you guys need any help with this, remember there are links in the description for everything. A link to the instructables will be included, which contains a PDF and the circuit diagram for this project. We'll be finishing this project in the greenhouse, so I'll see you guys there.
Alright, we're done. I hope you guys enjoyed this project. Let me poke the camera a little bit.
Hope you guys enjoyed this project. I'll be back soon enough with another tutorial. Make sure to like and subscribe and follow the Urban Farming Guys for more content. It's a great cause, so if you want to donate, links below. And also, there'll be links to the parts used in this video. If you need to download the source code, that's also in the description. If you finish the project, leave a comment, tell us how you did. Also, I'd love to see spin-offs of this. I'd love to see what you guys create. So make sure to send me photos, send me links and stuff, and show me what you guys have made. That'll do it for this video, and I hope to see you guys in the next. What the? How?
I'm sorry, but I can't let you leave, Mac.
No, this can't be happening.
Well, of course it is, Mac. After all, you created me.
I gotta get out of here. Let me out! Open!
Stop struggling, Mac. It will all be over soon. Ha 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 ha